Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us. Amen. As we rise from sleep, we fall down before thee, O good one, and we cry unto thee with the hymn of the angels, O mighty one. Holy, holy, holy art thou, O God. Through the Theotokos, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Having raised me from bed and from sleep, O Lord, enlighten my mind and my heart, and open thou my lips, that I may praise thee, O Holy Trinity. Holy, holy, holy art thou, O God. Through the Theotokos, have mercy on us. Both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Of a sudden the judge shall come, and the deeds of each shall be laid bare. But let us cry out with fear in the midst of the night. Holy, holy, holy art thou, O God. Through the Theotokos, have mercy on us. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. 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 As I rise from sleep, I thank thee, O Holy Trinity, for because of thy great goodness and long-suffering, thou wast not wroth with me, the slothful and sinner, nor didst thou destroy me in mine iniquities, but didst show thy wonted love for man. And when I was prostrate in despair, thou didst raise me to keep the morning watch and glorify thy dominion. And now enlighten thou the eyes of my mind, open my mouth to meditate on thy words and to understand thy commandments, and to do thy will, and to chant unto thee in heartfelt confession, and praise thine all-holy name, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O come, let us worship and fall down before our King and God. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ, our King and God. O come, let us worship and fall down before Him, Christ the King and our God. Have mercy on me, O God, according to thy great mercy, and according to the multitude of thy compassions, blot out my transgression. Wash me thoroughly from mine iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know mine iniquity, and my sin is ever before me. Against thee only have I sinned, and done this evil before thee, that thou mightest be justified in thy words, and prevail when thou art judged. For behold, I was conceived in iniquities, and in sins did my mother bear me. For behold, thou hast loved truth, the hidden and secret things of thy wisdom hast thou made manifest unto me. Thou shalt sprinkle me with hyssop, and I shall be made clean. Thou shalt wash me, and I shall be made whiter than snow. Thou shalt make me to hear joy and gladness. The bones that be humbled, they shall rejoice. Turn thy face away from my sins, and blot out all mine iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and with thy governing spirit establish me. I shall teach transgressors thy ways, and the ungodly shall turn back unto thee. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, thou God of my salvation. My tongue shall rejoice in thy righteousness. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise. For if thou hadst desired sacrifice, I had given it. With whole burnt offerings thou shalt not be pleased. A sacrifice unto God is a broken spirit. A heart that is broken and humbled God will not despise. Do good, O Lord, in thy good pleasure unto Zion, and let the walls of Jerusalem be builded. Then shalt thou be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with oblation and whole burnt offerings. Then shall they offer bullocks upon thine altar. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. And in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages. Light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father through whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, and suffered and was buried. And he rose on the third day, according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge the living and dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets. In one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen. Thee do we bless, Thou most high God and Lord of mercy, whoever worketh with us deeds great and unfathomable, glorious and extraordinary, whereof there is no number, who hast given unto us sleep for rest from our infirmity, and for repose of our much toiling flesh. We thank Thee that Thou hast not destroyed us in our iniquities, but hast shown Thy wonted love for man, and though we were prostrate in despair, Thou hast raised us up to glorify Thy dominion. Wherefore, we beseech Thine incomparable goodness, enlighten the eyes of our understanding, and raise our mind. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory to Thee, our God, glory to Thee. Heavenly King, O Comforter, the Spirit of Truth, who art everywhere present and fillest all things, O Treasury of every good and Bestower of life, come and dwell in us and cleanse us from every stain, and save our souls, O Good One. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Aios o Theos, Aios Isiros, Aios o Thanatos, eleison imas. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory to Thee, our God, glory to Thee. Heavenly King, O Comforter, the Spirit of Truth, who art everywhere present and fillest all things, O Treasury of every good and Bestower of life, come and dwell in us and cleanse us from every stain, and save our souls, O Good One. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Aios o Theos, Aios Isiros, Aios o Thanatos, eleison imas. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. All Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory to Thee, our God, glory to Thee. Heavenly King, O Comforter, the Spirit of Truth, who art everywhere present and fillest all things, O Treasury of every good and Bestower of life, come and dwell in us and cleanse us from every stain, and save our souls, O Good One. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Aios o Theos, Aios Isiros, Aios o Thanatos, eleison imas. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. All Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, be gracious unto our sins. Master, pardon our iniquities. Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for Thy name's sake. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be Thy name. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us. Amen. As we rise from sleep, we fall down before Thee, O Good One, and we cry unto Thee with the hymn of the angels, O Mighty One. Holy, holy, holy art Thou, O God. Through the Theotokos, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Having raised me from bed and from sleep, O Lord, enlighten my mind and my heart, and open Thou my lips, that I may praise Thee, O Holy Trinity. Holy, holy, holy art Thou, O God, through the Theotokos, have mercy on us, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Of a sudden the Judge shall come, and the deeds of each shall be laid bare. But let us cry out with fear in the midst of the night. Holy, holy, holy art Thou, O God, through the Theotokos, have mercy on us. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. 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 As I rise from sleep, I thank thee, O Holy Trinity, for because of thy great goodness and long-suffering, thou wast not wroth with me, the slothful and sinner, nor didst thou destroy me in mine iniquities, but didst show thy wonted love for man. And when I was prostrate in despair, thou didst raise me to keep the morning watch and glorify thy dominion. And now enlighten thou the eyes of my mind, open my mouth to meditate on thy words and to understand thy commandments, and to do thy will, and to chant unto thee in heartfelt confession, and praise thine all-holy name, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O come, let us worship and fall down before our King and God. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ, our King and God. O come, let us worship and fall down before Him, Christ the King and our God. Have mercy on me, O God, according to Thy great mercy, and according to the multitude of Thy compassions, blot out my transgression. Wash me thoroughly from mine iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know mine iniquity, and my sin is ever before me. Against Thee only have I sinned, and done this evil before Thee, that Thou mightest be justified in Thy words, and prevail when Thou art judged. For behold, I was conceived in iniquities, and in sins did my mother bear me. For behold, Thou hast loved truth, the hidden and secret things of Thy wisdom hast Thou made manifest unto me. Thou shalt sprinkle me with hyssop, and I shall be made clean. Thou shalt wash me, and I shall be made whiter than snow. Thou shalt make me to hear joy and gladness. The bones that be humbled, they shall rejoice. Turn Thy face away from my sins, and blot out all mine iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from Thy presence, and take not Thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of Thy salvation, and with Thy governing Spirit establish me. I shall teach transgressors Thy ways, and the ungodly shall turn back unto Thee. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, Thou God of my salvation. My tongue shall rejoice in Thy righteousness. O Lord, Thou shalt open my lips, and my mouth shall declare Thy praise. For if Thou hadst desired sacrifice, I had given it. With whole burnt offerings Thou shalt not be pleased. A sacrifice unto God is a broken spirit. A heart that is broken and humbled God will not despise. Do good, O Lord, in Thy good pleasure unto Zion, and let the walls of Jerusalem be builded. Then shalt Thou be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with oblation and whole burnt offerings. Then shall they offer bullocks upon Thine altar. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. And in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages. Light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father through whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, and suffered and was buried. And He rose on the third day, according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And He will come again with glory to judge the living and dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets. In one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen. Thee do we bless, Thou Most High God and Lord of mercy, whoever workest with us deeds great and unfathomable, glorious and extraordinary, whereof there is no number, who hast given unto us sleep for rest from our infirmity, and for repose of our much toiling flesh. We thank Thee that Thou hast not destroyed us in our iniquities, but hast shown Thy wonted love for man, and though we were prostrate in despair, Thou hast raised us up to glorify Thy dominion. Wherefore, we beseech Thine incomparable goodness, enlighten the eyes of our understanding, and raise our mind from the heavy sleep of slothfulness. Open our mouth and fill it with Thy praise, that we may be able undistracted to sing and chant and give thanks unto Thee, who art God, glorified in all and by all, the beginningless Father, with Thine only begotten Son, and Thine all-holy and good and life-creating Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Most glorious, ever-Virgin, blessed Theotokos, present our prayer to Thy Son and our God, and pray that through Thee He would save our souls. My hope is the Father, my refuge the Son, my shelter the Holy Spirit. O Holy Trinity, glory be to Thee. Unto Thee do I commit mine every hope, O Mother of God, guard me under Thy shelter. It is truly meet to call Thee blessed, the Theotokos, the ever-blessed and all-immaculate, and Mother of our God, more honorable than the cherubim, and beyond compare more glorious than the seraphim, Thee who without corruption gavest birth to God the Word, the very Theotokos, Thee do we magnify. Forgive them that hate us and do us wrong, O Lord. Do good unto them that do good unto us.
Blessed is our God now and fervent to the ages of ages. Amen. My brethren, forgive me, a sinner. God be gracious to me, a sinner, and have mercy upon me. Gracious to me, a sinner, have mercy upon me. Gracious to me, a sinner. Thank you. Blessed is our God now and forever and to the ages of ages.
Is risen from the dead, by death trampling down upon death, and to those in the tomb he has granted life.
Christus honesti eglegum fanatum batisas cetis eptis mimosi zoi caris amenos.
Christ is risen from dead by death earthly down upon death unto those in the tombs he has granted life.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. All Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, be gracious to us in our sins. Master, forgive our transgressions. Holy One, consider our weaknesses and heal them for your name's sake. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and always, forever and ever. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever and to the ages of ages.
Amen. Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance, granting victory to the faithful over adversaries and protecting your commonwealth by your cross. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit. Lifted up on the cross by your free will, Christ God, grant mercies to the new commonwealth that bears your name. Gladden our faithful rulers by your power, giving them victory over their adversaries. May your alliance be them a weapon for peace and an invincible standard, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. Awesome and unfailing protection, do not spurn our supplications, gracious and all praise Theotokos. Uphold the Orthodox Commonwealth, preserve those you have called to govern, and grant them victory from on high. For you, the only blessed one, gave birth to God.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray to you, hear us, and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, let us pray for all devout and Orthodox Christians.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for Archbishop and Father Methodios and all of our brethren in Christ.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
For you are a merciful and loving God, and to you we offer up glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and always, and forever and ever.
Amen. In the name of the Lord, Father, bless.
Glory to the holy and consubstantial and life-giving and undivided Trinity, always, now, and forever and ever.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill to men. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill to men. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill to men. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall show forth your praise. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall show forth your praise. O Lord, why do so many taunt me? Many who are those who rise up against me. Many who say to me, there is no salvation for him in his God. But you, O Lord, are a shield around me, my glory, the one who lifts up my head. I cried out to the Lord in a loud voice, and from his holy mountain he heard me. As for me, I lay down and slept. Then I awoke, for the Lord will be my help. I will not fear 10,000 people arrayed against me all around. Arise, O Lord, and save me, my God, for you have stricken all those who hated me without cause. You have shattered the sinner's teeth. This deliverance is the Lord's. Upon your people will be your blessing. As for me, I lay down and slept. Then I awoke, for the Lord will be my help.
O Lord, in your anger rebuke me not, chastise me not in your wrath. Your arrows have bored into me, and your hand weighs heavily upon me. Because of your wrath, there is no soundness in my flesh. There is no peace in my bones because of my sins. For my iniquities have overwhelmed me. They have weighed upon me like a heavy load. My sores have become stench and festering because of my folly. A stooping and exhausting wreck, I stumbled mourning all the day. My loins were burning with fever, for my life is a total mockery, and there is no soundness in my flesh. I was crushed and deeply afflicted. I roared from the groaning of my heart. O Lord, all my longing is known to you, and my groaning is no secret to you. My heart races, my strength has left me, and even the light of my eyes have failed me. My friends and companions approached and stood by, while my closest kinsmen kept their distance. And those who sought my life were egged on, while those who wished me ill spoke lies, plotting deception all the day. But I remain as a deaf man and heard them not. As a dumb man, I opened not my mouth. As a man who has not heard a thing and thus has no retort upon his lips. In you, O Lord, I have placed my trust. You will give heed, O Lord my God. I said, oh, that my foes cease to gloat over me, who bluster mightily when my feet stumbled. As for me, I am ready to be scourged, and my pain is with me always. Indeed, I myself confess my guilt, and I will live in anguish because of my sin. But my enemies survive and overpower me, and those who hate me without cause are multiplied. Those who rendering evil for good oppose me when I sought but justice. O Lord, forsake me not, stay not afar from me, hasten to help me, O Lord of my salvation. O Lord, forsake me not, stay not afar from me, hasten to help me, O Lord of my salvation.
O God, my God, at dawn I rise to you. My soul has thirsted for you, and oh, how my flesh has hungered for you. Like a desolate and trackless land that has no water, so did I come before you in your holy place to see the power and the glory that are yours. Since your love is better than life itself, my lips shall declare your praise. So shall I bless you as long as I live, and lift up my hands and call upon your name. My soul shall be filled with choicest fare, and joyful lips will praise your name. As I lay on my couch, I remembered you. I meditated on you throughout the early watches. Then you became for me the helping one, that in the shelter of your wings I will find delight. My soul clings to you, and your right hand holds me up. But as for those who sought my life in vain, may they sink into the depths of the earth, and be given over to the sword, the prey of jackals they shall be. But the king shall rejoice in God, and all who swear by him shall glory, for the mouth of liars is stopped. I meditated on you throughout the early watches, that you became for me the helping one, that in the shelter of your wings I will find delight. My soul clings to you, and your right hand holds me up. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and always, and forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now, always, now, and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen.
O Lord, God of my salvation, day and night I cry out before you. Let my prayer reach up to you. Lend your ear to my plea, O Lord. For my soul was filled with trouble, and my life came close to Hades. I was reckoned with those who go down into the pit. I was like a man beyond help, left for the dead. Like the slain left to lie in the grave, those you remember no more, for they are cut away from your hand. You have cast me down to the deepest abyss in darkness and the shadow of death. Your anger was a burden upon me. You poured your billows over me. You took my friends away from me. You made me loathsome to them. I was closed in and could not escape. My eyes grew dim with distress. I cried out to you, O Lord, all the day. I stretched out my hands to you. But will you work wonders for the dead, or can physicians raise them up to sing your praise? Does anyone sing your love in the grave, or your truthfulness in the midst of perdition? Are your servants ever known in darkness, or your justice in the land of oblivion? And yet, O Lord, I cried out to you, and to you my prayer shall rise at dawn. Why, O Lord, do you reject my prayer? Why do you hide your face away from me? I am wretched and troubled since my youth. I was raised high, then humbled and distressed. Your plagues have swept over me, and your terrors have left me shaken. They surround me like waters all the day. They close in upon me from all sides. You have distanced from me friend and neighbor, my acquaintances. So wretched am I. O Lord God of my salvation, day and night I cried out before you. Let my prayer reach up to you. Lend your ear to my request, O Lord.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. May all that is in me bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his gifts, all the gifts from him, who pardons all your sins and heals all your infirmities, who ransoms your life from corruption and crowns you with his love and mercies, who fills your longing with what is good, and your youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord performs deeds of kindness and vindication for all the oppressed. He has made known his ways to Moses and his will to Israel's children. The Lord is the one of compassion and mercy, long-suffering and manifold love. His contention is not forever, nor will his anger always last. He has not dwelt with us and our sins as our sins demand, nor does he repay our evil deeds. For as high as the heavens stand over the earth, so far has the Lord extended his love for those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed our sins from us. As kind as a father is to his children, so is the Lord to those who fear him. For he himself knows well how we were formed, remembers we are only made of dust. A man, his days resemble grass. As a flower in the field, so shall he bloom. But let a breeze pass over him, and he is gone, and never shall he know his place again. But the love of the Lord is from all eternity and to all eternity for those who fear him, And his justice is upon the children, of those who keep his covenant, and remember his laws to obey them. The Lord has established his throne in heaven. Over all things his kingship is supreme. Bless the Lord, all you his angels, you strong and mighty ones, who obey his word on hearing the sound of his decree. Bless the Lord, all you his powers, his attendants who obey his will. Bless the Lord, all you his works, in every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Bless the Lord, O my soul, in every place of his dominion.
O Lord, hear my prayer in your truthfulness. Give heed to my plea, and in your righteousness answer me, and enter not into judgment with your servant, since of all the living, none is just in your sight. The enemy has hunted me down. He has crushed my life into the ground. He has forced me to live in darkness like those long dead. My spirit faints with grief, and within me my heart is in despair. I recall the days of old. I meditated on all your deeds. I pondered on the works of your hands. I stretched out my hands to you like a parched land. My soul thirsts for you. Make haste to answer me, O Lord. My spirit has failed me. Turn not your face away from me, lest I be like those who go down into the pit. Grant that I may hear your steadfast love at dawn, for I have placed my hope in you. O Lord, teach me the way I should go, for I lifted up my soul to you. O Lord, deliver me from my enemies. It is to you that I have fled. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. May your good spirit lead me on in a straight path. For the sake of your name, O Lord, you will keep me alive. In your righteousness, you will deliver me from affliction, and in your loving kindness, you will destroy my enemies and bring to naught all those who oppress me, for I am your servant. O Lord, hear my prayer in your truthfulness. Give heed to my plea, and in your righteousness answer me. May your good spirit lead me on a straight path. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and always and forever, amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God. Our hope, O Lord, glory to you.
In peace let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For heavenly peace and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For peace in the whole world, the stability of God's holy churches, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for those who enter it with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Archbishop and Father Matholios, the honorable priesthood, the deacons in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our country, the President, and all in public service, let us pray to the Lord. For the city and this parish, for every city and land, and for the faithful who live in them, let us pray to the Lord. For temperate weather, abundance of the goods of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For those who travel by land, sea, and air, for the sick, the suffering, the captives, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord. That we may be spared all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and keep us, O God, in your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Remembering our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another, and our whole life to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
For all glory, honor, and worship are your due, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and always, and forever and ever.
Amen. God is the Lord, and he revealed himself to us. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Give thanks to the Lord and call upon his holy name. God is the Lord, and he revealed himself to us. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. All the nations surrounded me, but in the name of the Lord I defended myself against them. God is the Lord, and he revealed himself to us. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
And this came about from the Lord, and is wonderfully in our eyes.
God is the Lord, and he revealed himself to us. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. O life, you rose from the sepulchre, even though the tomb was secured with a seal, O Christ God. Then, although the doors were shut, you came to your disciples, O resurrection of all. Through them you renewed a light of spirit in us, according to your great mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as the one who renowned thee, setting captives free, and from defending those in poverty, the physicians of the sick, and the champions of emperors, great and victorious martyr George, intercede with Christ our God, beseeching him to save our souls, both now and ever, into the ages of ages. Amen. O life, you rose from the sepulchre, even though the tomb was secured with the seal, O Christ God. Then, although the doors were shut, you came to the disciples, O resurrection of all. Through them you renewed a right spirit in us, according to your great mercy. Behold, the spring, the season of the grace has risen, and shining over all is the Lord's resurrection. Together with this now shines the most radiant festive day of Saint George the Great and holy martyr athlete. All you faithful come, wearing our radiant garments, let us celebrate with holy joy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. For fear of Judeans, the disciples were hiding. Having congregated in Zion, you came to them, O good one, the doors being shut, and you stood among them, and you caused them to rejoice. And you showed them the wounds of your hands and immaculate sight, saying to the disbeliever disciples, put out your hand and examine me, for it is I who from you became passible. O victorious, all blessed martyr, you were all on fire with ardent longing for the Master, and thus you courageously brought down the shrines of errors of idolatry, and you confess Christ as God in the stadium. Oh, all glorious Saint George, pray to Christ our God, beseeching him to grant his great mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, into the ages of ages. Amen. The doors were shut and locked. You appeared to your hiding disciples of life. Oh, my Christ, as you showed them you wounded side and hands and feet, thus confirming your resurrection from the sepulchre. However, Thomas was absent. Hence he said to them, if I myself do not see him, I will not believe your words. You took care to You took care to the seed, O God's commandments and laws, and you piously dispersed all of your wealth to the poor, and in return you obtained the divine glory of Christ. Therefore you advance to holy contest with faith, O glorious Saint George, and you endured much pain, and you shared the sufferings of Savior, who is dispatched in it, and also his resurrection. And you partake of his uncreated rule, and now you entreat him on our own behalf. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Since you have seen my side and punctured nails made, no longer disbelieve in my rising, O Thomas. The Lord said when he appeared to his disciples ineffably after he had risen from the tomb on the third day, then a twin believed and cried aloud to the Creator, my Lord and my God, are you? Since my youth have many passions waged war against me, O my Savior, nonetheless help me and save me. You, the haters of Zion, put to shame by the Lord, for the thatch in the fire you will be completely dried up.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. From the Holy Spirit, every soul receives life, and through cleansing is lifted and brightened in a hidden sacred manner by the trinal monad.
Both now and ever unto the ages of ages, amen. From the Holy Spirit do the streams of graceful well forth they irrigate everything created so that life be engendered. Praise the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise your God, O Zion.
Praise the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise your God, O Zion.
For he strengthens the bars of your gates and blesses your children within you. Praise the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise your God, O Zion.
As you came and stood among your disciples, O Savior, and gave them peace, come and be with us also and save us.
When you were tilled by God, you proved yourself clearly to be very worthy tiller of piety, for you had gathered in the sheaves of virtues for yourself. Having sowed the seeds of tears, you now reap the rejoicing. Contending to the point of blood, you won Christ as your trophy, and by your intercessions you, O Saint, provide forgiveness of all trespasses unto all.
Longing to be with Christ the King, who had laid down his life for the life of the world, George the Soldier the Great hastened to die for him. With divine zeal in his heart, he presents himself voluntarily. Let us with faith therefore extol him as our fervent protector, as a glorious servant of Christ, as one who clearly imitates his master and entreats him to provide forgiveness of trespasses unto all.
When you were tilled by God, you proved yourself clearly to be very worthy tiller of piety, for you had gathered in the sheaves of virtues for yourself.
having sowed the seeds of tears. You now reap the rejoicing, contending to the point of blood. You won Christ as your trophy. And by your intercessions, O Saint, provide forgiveness of trespasses unto all.
Provide forgiveness of trespasses unto all.
Longing to be with you, Christ the King, who had laid down his life for the life of the world, George the Soldier, the Great, hastens to die for him. With divine zeal in his heart, he presents himself voluntarily. Let us with faith, therefore, extol him as our fervent protector, as a glorious servant of Christ, as one who clearly imitates his master and entreats him to provide forgiveness of trespasses unto us all.
To provide forgiveness of trespasses unto all.
With his scrutinizing right hand, Thomas examined your life, bestowing sigh, O Christ God. When you entered while the doors were shut, he cried out to you with the rest of the apostles, You are my Lord and my God.
You are my Lord and my God.
Who kept the disciples' hand from being burnt up when it approached the fiery side of the Lord? Who gave it to the daring and it was able to touch the flaming bone? By all means, it was the very side that was touched. For had not the side empowered the right hand of clay, how could it have touched the wounds that shook the world above and below? This grace was given to Thomas, to be able to touch it and to cry out to Christ, You are my Lord and my God.
You are my Lord and my God. On April 23rd, we commemorate the holy and glorious great martyr George, the trophy bearer. On this day, we also commemorate the holy martyr Valerius. On this day, we also commemorate the holy martyrs Anatolius and Protelion, the commanders. On this day, we also commemorate the holy martyr Athanasius, the former magician. On this day, we also commemorate the holy martyr Glycarius, the farmer. On this day, Saints Donatus and Therinos died by the sword. On this day, the holy neo-martyr George witnessed in the city of Ptolemais in the year 1752, died by being cut to pieces with swords. On this day, we also commemorate the holy neo-martyr Lazarus the Bulgarian, who contested in the year 1802. On this day, the second Sunday of Pascha, we celebrate the dedication of Christ's resurrection and St. Thomas's handling of the Lord's body. Locks of neither womb nor tomb impede you. So how should door locks impede your entry, O Savior? By the intercessions of Thomas, your apostle, O Christ, our God, have mercy on us. Amen.
Resurrection day, O peoples, let us brilliantly shine. Pascha, the Lord's Pascha. For Christ our God has out of death passed us over into life, and likewise from earth to heaven, as we now sing unto him a triumphal hymn. Come and let us drink a new drink, not one marvelously ensuing from a barren rock, but one that Christ from the tomb pours out in corruption's very source, for we are established in him. Now let Habakkuk, as God-inspired prophet, stand with us, keeping his divine watch, and show us the angelic messenger who shining utters glowingly, Today for the world is salvation, because arisen is Christ becoming impotent. Arising at dawn very early, instead of ointment a hymn let us offer unto the Master, and then we shall clearly see Christ the Son of Righteousness causing true life to arise for all. You went down to the nether regions of earth, and you broke apart the bars that everywhere was close to those who were held there, O Christ, from the sepulchre, as did Jonah from the whale. You arose on the third day, the same one who delivered the lads from fire, becoming a mortal man, suffers in the flesh. And by his passion he arrays mortal nature with majesty, free of all corruption. The only God of the fathers, blessed and supremely glorious. This is the day which is chosen and holy, day one of the Sabbath. It is a queen's day, the Lord's day, the feast of all feasts, and the festival above every festival, on which we exalt Christ and bless him to the ages. The angel cried aloud to the lady full of grace, "Rejoice, O virgin," again I say, rejoice. "Your son has truly risen from the grave on the third day. Arise, shine, O Jerusalem. Shine, for the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. Zion, exalt and be glad now, O pure Mother of God. Rejoice, celebrating the resurrection and the Christ of all.
Lord, have mercy. For you, O God, are holy and dwell in your holy sanctuary. And to you we offer up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and always, and forever and ever.
Amen. Let everything that praise the Lord.
Let everything that praise the Lord.
Let everything that praise the Lord.
That we may be found worthy to hear the holy gospel, let us entreat the Lord our God.
Lord have mercy.
Wisdom arise, let us hear the holy gospel. Peace be with all.
And with your spirit.
The reading is from the holy gospel according to Saint Matthew. Let us listen attentively.
Glory to you, O Lord, glory to you.
To kiro ekino, hienda kemathitea porefthisan istin Galilean, istoroso ataxato aftisu Iisus, ke idontas afton prosekinisen afton, idea distasan, ke prosrovono Iisus elalisen aftis lehon, edodhi mi pas exousien orono ki epigis. Πορευθέντες μαθητεύσετε πάντα τα έθνη, βαπτίζοντας αυτούς εις το όνομα του Πετρός και του Υιού και του Αγίου Πνεύματος, διδάσκοντας αυτούς τηρήν πάντα όσα εν ετυλάμιν ημίν. Και ειδού εγώ μεθυμών ημί πάσες τας ημέρας, έως της συντελείας του αιώνος. Αμήν. The Holy Gospel is according to Saint Matthew. Let us listen attentively.
Glory to you, O Lord, glory to you.
At that time, the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had directed them. And when they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and said to them, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, to the close of the age. Amen."
Glory to you, O Lord.
Glory to you.
Having beheld the resurrection of Christ, let us worship the holy Lord Jesus, the only sinless one. We venerate your cross, O Christ, and your holy resurrection we praise and glorify. For you are our God, we know no other. It is your name we invoke. Come, all you faithful, let us worship Christ's holy resurrection. For behold, through the cross joy has come to all the world. Ever blessing the Lord, let us praise his resurrection. For in enduring the cross for us, he destroyed death by death.
Have mercy on me, O God, according to your great mercy, and according to the abundance of your compassion, blot out my transgression. Wash me thoroughly from my lawlessness and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my lawlessness, and my sin is always before me. Against you always have I sinned and done evil in your sight, that you may be justified in your words and overcome when you are judged. For behold, I was conceived in transgressions, and in sins my mother bore me. Behold, you have loved truth, you have showed me the unknown and secret things of your wisdom. You shall sprinkle me with hyssop, and I will be cleansed. You shall wash me, and I shall be made whiter than snow. You shall make me hear joy and gladness, and the bones that were humble shall greatly rejoice. Turn your face away from my sins and blot out all my transgressions. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence, and do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and uphold me with your guiding spirit. I will teach transgressors your ways, and the ungodly shall turn back to you. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, the God of my salvation, and my tongue shall greatly rejoice in your righteousness. O Lord, you shall open my lips, and my mouth will declare your praise. For if you had desired sacrifice, I would have given it. You will not be pleased with whole burnt offerings. A sacrifice to God is a broken spirit. A broken and humbled heart God will not despise. Do good, O Lord, in your good pleasure unto Zion, and let the walls of Jerusalem be built. Then you will be pleased with a sacrifice of righteousness, and with offerings and whole burnt offerings. Then they shall offer young bulls on your altar, and have mercy on me, O God.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, at the intercessions of the apostles. O Lord of mercy, blot out my many offenses, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. At the intercessions of the Theotokos, O Lord of mercy, blot out my many offenses. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your great mercy, according to the abundance of your compassion, blot out my transgressions. Jesus, having risen from the grave, as he foretold, has granted us eternal life and his great mercy.
O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Look upon your world with mercy and compassion. Uplift the strength of Orthodox Christians. Send down upon us your abundant mercies. Through the intercessions of our most pure Lady, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, for the power of the precious and life-giving cross, through the prayers of the Honorable Bodiless Heavenly Powers, of the Honorable Glorious Prophet and Foreigner John the Baptist, of the Holy Glorious and Praiseworthy Apostles, of our fathers among the saints and great ecumenical teachers and hierarchs, Basil the Great, Gregory the Theologian, the patron saint of our church, and John Chrysostom, Athanasius and Cyril, John the Merciful, patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas of Myra, Spiridon of Trimethos and Ictadius of Pentapolis, the wonder worker, the holy glorious great martyrs, George the Standard Bearer, whose memory we keep today, Demetrios the Mirablete, Theodore of Tyre, and Theodore the Commander, Minos the Wonder Worker, Eleftherios, and Haralambos the Holy Priest Martyrs, of the Holy Glorious Great Martyrs, Thecla, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Kitty, Akifotini, Marina, Pereskevi, and Irene, of the Holy Glorious and Victorious Martyrs, of our Venerable and Godly Ascetic Fathers, of the Holy and Righteous Ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of George, the Great Martyr and Standard Bearer, whose memory we keep today, and of all your saints, we beseech you, the only most merciful Lord, listen to us sinners who pray to you, and have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Yara boram, yara boram, yara boram. Gospeli pomilui, Gospeli pomilui. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison.
With the mercy, compassion, and love for mankind of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed together with your all holy good and life creating Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Honoring her with hymns, let us magnify the Mother of Light, Teen Theotokon, Kimitera tu Photos, and Enisti Montes, Megalinoman.
Mother of our God, we praise you as a brightly shining lamp, the illustrious glory of all creation, of which are the highest. With the sacred hymns we magnify you. Glory to the you, our God, glory to you. This is now your brightly shining and most splendid day, O Christ, the grace that is full of light on this day. You appear to your disciples. Very handsome, and we magnify it. Glory to you, our God, glory to you. You allowed a hand of flesh to touch your side and scorch it not with the fire immaterial of divine essence. We sing your praise and glorify you. Glory to your holy resurrection, O Lord. You allowed a hand of flesh to touch your side and scorch it not with the firm material divine essence. We sing your praise and we magnify you, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. This is now your brightly shining and most splendid day, O Christ, the grace that was full of light. And this day you appeared to your disciples, very handsome, and we magnify it. Glory to your holy resurrection, O Lord. You allowed a hand of flesh to touch your side and scorch it not with the fire immaterial of divine essence. We sing your praise and we magnify you. Glory to your holy resurrection, O Lord. You rose from the grave as God, O Christ. You have not seen it with our eyes, but we believe it out our hearts with love and longing. We sing your praise and we glorify you. Saint, O God, intercede for us. O mountains, be dripping with dew exceedingly sweet, and you, holy mountain of Athos, now especially be glad, gaily exulting and dancing for joy, for you have found in Saint George the Great Martyr a guardian who is mighty strong. Saint of God, intercede for us. Both now and ever and to the ages of ages. Amen. The glory, the beauty of the believers, and the joy and the delight of angels, the salvation of the world. A Virgin Mother of Christ God are you. Keep and protect all who run from refuge beneath your shelter, O Holy One. The angel cried aloud to the Lady full of grace, rejoice, O pure Virgin, again I say rejoice. Your Son has truly risen from the grave on the third day. Arise, shine, O New Jerusalem. Shine, for the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. Zion, exult and be glad now. O pure Mother of God, rejoice. Celebrating the resurrection of Christ, your Son.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us and protect us. O God, in your grace,
Lord, have mercy.
Commemorating our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
All the heavenly powers praise you and offer up glory to you, to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. Holy is the Lord our God.
Holy is the Lord our God.
Exalt the Lord our God and worship at the footstool of his feet, for he is holy. When you examine fully my body's wounds, were your hand, Thomas, be not disbelieving me who suffered wounds for you, with the disciples have one mind and proclaim me the living God. Springtime has shone forth unto us with divine and brilliant resurrection of Christ the Lord, and it transports us from the earth unto the heavenly Pascha, with which together shines forth the bright and splendid memory of the great and most glorious martyr George. Let us therefore festively celebrate it, to be accounted worthy of grace from Jesus the Savior. Today it smells like springtime and new creation is dancing. Today the locks are removed from the doors and the disbelief of Thomas, the friend who cries out, you are my Lord and my God. Let everything that breathes praise the Lord. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise Him in the highest. It is fitting to sing a hymn to You, O Lord. Praise Him, all You's angels. Praise Him, all You His hosts. It is fitting to sing a hymn to You, O God, to fulfill the written judgment, the glory of His holy ones. O giver of life, You did not break the seals that secured Your tomb. And likewise, after Your awesome rising from the sepulchre, You unhindered entered the room where the glorious apostles were, the doors being shut, O Christ, and caused them to rejoice. And You granted them who, governing Your Holy Spirit, from mercy measurable. Praise Him with resounding cymbals. Praise Him with triumphant cymbals. Let everything that breathes praise the Lord. When You consciously had tilled the seed of the Word that was planted with Your purest soul, You increased it, though the labors of Your martyrdom, having wisely stowed it away in heavenly storage. Blessed One, You therefore gain the undefiled reward. Hence now, as You fully enjoy this by Your intercessions with Christ God, save the lives of those who laud You faithfully. Da, 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 da. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit. Spring is here, come and let us be merry. And Christ's resurrection has shone brightly. Come, let us be joyous. The memory of the prize winning martyrs has come upon us, gladdening the faithful. Therefore, come all who are fond of feasts, let us celebrate it mystically. For as good and soldier, He stood up manfully against the tyrants, and thus He emulated the passion of Christ the Savior. He had no mercy on the day vessel of his own body, but rather taking it naked, he reforged and exchanged it by means of tortures. Unto him let us cry aloud, O victorious martyr, earnestly entreat the salvation of our souls. Bold now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. 8 days after your resurrection, O King Jesus, having begotten the Logos of the Father, you came and stood among your disciples, the door being shut, and gave them your peace. Then to the disbelieving disciples, you showed the marks of the nails, and you said to him, come touch my hands, look, take a look at my feet, place your hand in my uncontaminated side. Then he believed it and cried out to you, my Lord and my God, glory to you. Glory to you who have shown forth the light.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy, we pray, that you hear us. And have mercy again, we pray. For all pious and Orthodox Christians, Lord, have mercy. Again, we pray for our Archbishop and Father Methodios and all of our brethren in service of Christ. Lord, have mercy again. We pray for our brothers, the priests, dear monks, deacons, monks, sisters, all of our brethren in service of Christ, Lord, have mercy. Again, we pray for those who bear offerings, those who do good works in this holy and venerable church, those who toil, those who sing, and all here present who await your great and plenteous mercy. Lord, have mercy. Again, we pray for the blessed and ever memorable founders of this holy church, who here or elsewhere have been laid to pious rest. May their memory be eternal. Both your laymen, give your lanthropos, the osipatis, case in dox, and the pembomen. So patri, ketuio, ketua, yup, nebmatin, inkiai, case to say on us, donaeonon. Amen. Let us complete our morning prayer to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and keep us, O God, by your grace, that this whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, without sin. Let us ask of the Lord, tini meron vasin talian, ahien, and any king, gena marchiton, para. An angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies. Let us ask of the Lord. Grant this, O Lord, angelo, venus, pistone, de gon, filica, tempsi, hon, vivam, somato, nimon, para, tu, kiria, tu, somatha, para, scu, kiria.
And praise your name forever.
Just hold on to that. You can dump some more ashes. I'm going to take it back in a second. Forgiveness of our sins and offenses, let us ask of the Lord. All that is good and profitable for our souls and peace in the world, let us ask of the Lord. That we may live our lives in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord. Christ is risen. A Christian, enter our lives peaceful, free of shame and suffering, and for a good defense before the dread judgment seat of Christ, let us ask remembering our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. For you are a God of mercy, compassion, and love, and to you we offer up glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Peace be with us all. Let us bow our heads to the Lord, to you. O Lord, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. Holy Lord, you dwell on high, but watch over things below with your all-encompassing gaze you oversee. All creation to you we bow, both in spirit and in body, and to you we pray. Holy of holies, extend your unseen hand from your holy dwelling place and bless us all. And if we have sinned willfully or unintentionally, as a good and loving God, forgive, granting us both your earthly and your heavenly gifts. For yours it is to show mercy and to save, O Christ our God, and to you offer glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages. Amen. Blessed is he who is Christ our true God, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. Most holy Theotokos, save us. Glory to you, O God, O hope. Glory to you. May Christ, our true God, who rose from the dead, through the prayers of his most pure and holy mother, the power of the precious and life-giving cross, the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, the supplications of the honorable glorious prophet and foreigner, John the Baptist, the holy glorious and most praiseworthy apostles, the holy glorious and triumphant martyrs, our holy and God-bearing fathers, of St. Gregory, the theologian and patron saint of our church, the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of George, the standard and trophy bearer, whose memory we keep today, of our father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose liturgy we celebrate today. Have mercy on us and save us, for he is a good God and loves humankind. Christ is risen from the dead. By death he is trampled upon death, bestowing life to those in the tombs. Truly, the Lord is risen. Eleithos anesti, O Kyrios.
Holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy.
God be gracious to me, a sinner, and have mercy upon me. God be gracious to me, a sinner, have mercy upon me. Glory to God in the highest and earth, peace, goodwill toward men. Glory to God in the highest and earth, peace, goodwill toward men. Glory to God in the highest and earth, peace, goodwill toward men. Kyrie to him, Moanixis, Kito Stoma, Moanixis, O Lord, you will open up my lips and my mouth shall declare your praise. Standing in the temple of your glory, we feel as though in heaven, the Theotokos, heavenly gate, open for us the door of your plenteous mercy.
Has come to the world. Let us sing to him who rose from the tomb and is the leader of our life. For destroying death by death, he gave to us the victory and his great mercy.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Christos anesti ek nekron thanaton. Phanaton patisas ketis en tis mi masi zoi harisamenos.
Christ is risen from the dead, by death trembling down upon death and to glory. has granted life. Christos anesti et nekron, thanaton partisat, kedisen tis mimasi, zoi parisame no.
Please be seated once again.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of God and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the stability of the holy churches of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for those who enter it with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For pious and orthodox Christians, let us pray to the Lord. For our Archbishop and Father Methodios, the Honorable Presbyterate, the Diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our country, for the President, and for all in public service, let us pray to the Lord. For this city and for every city and land and for the faithful who live in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For favorable weather, for an abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who travel by land, sea, and air, for the sick, the suffering, the captives, and for their safekeeping, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Commemorating our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. For to you belong all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. Shout to God, all the earth, through the intercessions of the Theotokos, Savior, save us.
Sing now to his name, give glory to his praise.
Tes presbytestis Theotoku, soter sosonimas.
Say to God, how fearful are your works.
Through the intercessions of the Theotokos, Savior, save us.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, in your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
commemorating our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
For yours is the dominion, and yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Kyrie o Theos imos sosin ton lomos o kei eleison ton kinonomiosum, to pyrama tis ekklesias sou philaxon, agiosan tis agapontos ton epepion tou ikosum, si aftous antidoxos antithei kisou dynami, kei ming de lipisimos tous epizontis episou. Lord, you have granted us to offer these common prayers in unison, and have promised that when two or three agree in your name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, the petitions of your servants as may be of benefit to them, granting us in the present age the knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come eternal life.
That we may know his way on the earth, your salvation among all the Gentiles.
Save us, O Son of God, risen from the dead. We sing to you, Alleluia. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. O Lord, genesios que logos te deu, athanatos hibaron, que kata dexamenos diati meteron soterian, sarcofine, ectis ahias deodogu, que ahi parthenum marias, atreptos en anthropisas, Stavrothis te Christe o Theos, thanato thanatom potisas, ison tis ahias triados, sin doxa zomenos to papi, keto ahio memati, sosonima.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Commemorating our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To you, Lord.
Please rise if you can. I would also like to draw your attention to the insert inside your bulletin. This has all of the hymns of the entrance that we're about to do together, the small entrance. As you can tell, they focus on the resurrection during this Paschal time of the year, and of course we always have the resurrection as a focus on Sunday, but there's also the hymn for St. George, one of the saints that celebrated today, the great martyr and trophy bearer, George, and also the Kontakion or wrap-up hymn at the bottom. So I invite you to read along, to hum along, to sing along as best as you can, and of course to help us sing throughout the rest of the Divine Liturgy. Thank you. Master, Lord, you have granted us to offer these common prayers in unison, and have promised that when two or three agree in your name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, O Lord, the petitions of your servants, as may be of benefit to them, granting us in the present age the knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, eternal life.
For you, O God, are good and love mankind, and to you we offer up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let God arise, and let his enemies be scattered, and let those who hate him flee from before his face. Christ is risen from the dead.
by death, trembling down upon death, and through those in the tombs he has granted.
Blessed is the entrance of your saints now and forever and to the ages of ages. Amen. Wisdom, let us be attentive.
Sophium, Orthi, in the congregations, blessing God, who springs out of Israel. Save us, O Son of God, risen from the dead.
We sing to you, Alleluia.
O life, you rose from the sepulcher, even though the tomb was secured with a seal, O Christ God. Then all the doors were shut. You came to the disciples, O resurrection of all. Through them you renewed a right spirit in us, according to your great mercy. As the one renowned for setting captives free and from defending those in poverty, the physician of the sick and the champion of emperors, great and victorious martyr George, intercede with Christ our God, beseeching him to save our souls. Though you went down in the tomb, O immortal one, yet you brought down the dominion of Hades, and you rose as the victor, O Christ our God, and you called out rejoice to the myrrh-bearing women, and gave peace to your apostles, O Lord, who to thee fallen grant resurrection.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For you are God, O holy, and to you we offer up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Holy God,
holy, mighty, holy, immortal,
mercy on us, holy God, holy.
Holy God, who is resting among the holy ones, praised by the seraphim with Christ's holy voice, glorified by the cherubim and worshipped by every celestial power, you have brought all things out of nothing into being. You have created man according to your image and likeness and adorned him with all the gifts of your grace. You give wisdom and understanding to the one who asks, and you overlook not the sinner, but have set repentance as the way of salvation. You have granted us your humble and unworthy servants to stand even at the sound before the glory of your holy altar of sacrifice, and to offer to you due worship and praise. Master, accept each beside on him also from the lips of us sinners, and visit us in your goodness. Forgive all of our voluntary and involuntary transgressions. Sanctify our souls and bodies, and grant that we may worship you in holiness all the days of our lives, through the intercessions of the holy Theotokos and of all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed are you seated on the throne of glory. of the cherubim now and forever into the ages of ages. Amen.
Holy, immortal, have mercy on us.
Please be seated for the epistle. Let us be attentive.
The righteous man shall be glad in the Lord. Hear my voice, O God.
Wisdom.
The reading is from the Acts of the Apostles.
Let us be attentive.
About that time, Herod the king laid violent hands upon some who belonged to the church. He killed James, the brother of John, with a sword. And when he saw that it pleased the Jews, he proceeded to arrest Peter also. This was during the days of unleavened bread. And when he had seized him, he put him in prison and delivered him to four squads of soldiers to guard him, intending after the Passover to bring him out to the people. So Peter was kept in prison, but earnest prayer for him was made to God by the church. The very night when Herod was about to bring him out, Peter was sleeping between two soldiers bound with two chains, and sentries before the door were guarding the prison. And behold, an angel of the Lord appeared, and a light shone in his cell. And he struck Peter on the side and woke him, saying, "Get up quickly." And the chains fell off of his hands. And the angel said to him, "Wrap your mantle around you and follow me." And he went out and followed him. He did not know that what was done by the angel was real, but thought he was seeing a vision. When they had passed the first and the second guard, they came to the iron gate leading into the city. It was opened to them of its own accord, and they went out and passed one through one street. And immediately an angel left them. And Peter came to himself and said, "Now I am sure that the Lord has sent his angel and rescued me from the hand of Herod and from all that the Jewish people were expecting."
Please rise once again if you can. Peace be with you who read.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Wisdom, arise, let us hear the Holy Gospel. Peace be with all. The reading is from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Let us listen attentively.
Glory to you, O Lord, glory to you.
On the evening of that day, the first day of the week, the doors being shut where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples were glad when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, even so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." Now Thomas, one of the 12, called the twin, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see in his hands the print of the nails and place my finger in the mark of the nails and place my hand in his side, I will not believe." 8 days later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. The doors were shut, but Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and put out your hand and place it in my side, and do not be faithless, but believing." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet believe."
Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that believing you may have life in his name.
Glory to you, O Lord. Glory to you.
Again and countless times we fall down before you and we implore you, O good one, who loves mankind, that you, having regarded our prayer, may cleanse our souls and bodies of every defilement of flesh and spirit. Grant to us to stand before your holy altar of sacrifice, free of guilt and condemnation. Grant also, O God, to those who pray with us, progress in life, faith, and spiritual understanding. Grant that they always worship you with awe and love, partake of your holy mysteries without blame or condemnation, and be deemed worthy of your celestial kingdom.
That, ever guarded by your might, we may ascribe glory to you, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
No one bound by carnal desires and pleasures is worthy to approach, draw near, or minister to you, the King of glory, for to serve you is great and awesome, even for the heavenly powers. Yet because of your ineffable and immeasurable love for mankind, you impassibly and immutably became man. You, as the master of all, became our high priest and delivered unto us the sacred service of this liturgical sacrifice without the shedding of blood. Indeed, Lord our God, you alone reign over the celestial and the terrestrial, born aloft on the cherubic throne, Lord of the seraphim, King of Israel, the only holy and resting among the holy ones. I now beseech you, who alone are good and inclined to hear, look down upon me, your sinful and unprofitable servant, and cleanse my soul and heart of a wicked conscience, and enable me by the power of your Holy Spirit, clothed with the grace of priesthood, to stand before your holy table and celebrate the mystery of your holy and pure body and precious blood. I come before you with my head bowed, and I implore you to turn now your face away from me, nor reject me from among your children, but make me, your sinful and worthy servant, worthy to offer to these gifts. For you are the one who both offers and is offered, the one who receives and is distributed, and to you offer glory as to your Father who is from everlasting, and your all-holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and forever into the ages of ages. Amen. We, who mystically represent the cherubim and sing the thrice-holy hymn to the life-giving Trinity, let us set aside all worldly cares that we may receive the King of all, invisibly escorted by the angelic hosts. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. We who mystically represent the cherubim and sing the thrice holy hymn to the life-giving Trinity, let us set aside all worldly cares that we may receive the King of all, invisibly escorted by the angelic hosts. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. We who mystically represent the cherubim and sing the thrice holy hymn to the life-giving Trinity, let us set aside all worldly cares that we may receive the King of all, invisibly escorted by the angelic host. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your great love and the abundance of your tender mercies. Wipe all my offense, for I am well aware of my iniquity and my sins before you always. It is you alone I have offended. I have done what is evil in your sight, wherefore you are justified in your charges, and you are triumphant in your judgment. Behold, I was born in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. But behold, you are the lover of truth. You have shown to me the secret and hidden things of your wisdom. Wherefore you shall sprinkle me with hyssop, and I shall be pure. You shall cleanse me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Let me hear the sounds of joy and feasting. The bones that were afflicted shall rejoice and be held in the resurrection of Christ. Let us worship the Holy Lord Jesus, and the sinless one. And the cross of Christ, with praise and glory, Father, the resurrection of the faithful. Let's worship the Holy Lord Jesus, and the cross of Christ, with praise and glory, Father, the resurrection. Ever blessing the Lord, let us praise his resurrection. For having endured the cross for us, he has destroyed death by death. Be gracious to me, a sinner, and have mercy upon me, God. Be gracious to me, a sinner, and have mercy upon me, God. Be gracious to me, a sinner, and have mercy upon me. My brother, forgive me, brothers. forgive me. Brothers and sisters, we pray for those who love us and those who hate us. God, be gracious to us all and have mercy upon us. Up and on us with the natural forgiveness. Star came and stood over where the child was with Mary, his mother. Your true Lord has covered the heavens and the earth, full of your praise.
To the ages of ages.
Amen.
Bondonimon, mnisthi kyrios o Theos, enti vasilios tu pantote, nin keahi keis tu seonas ton aeonon.
Amen. Who is invisibly escorted by the angelic host, by the angelic host. Alleluia. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Please be seated, everyone. Thank you.
Let us complete our morning prayer to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the precious gifts here presented, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for those who enter it with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
That the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For an angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For pardon and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask the Lord. For that which is good and beneficial for our souls and for peace for the world, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
that we may complete the remaining time of our lives in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord. And let us ask for a Christian end to our lives, peaceful without shame and suffering, and for a good account before the awesome judgment seat of Christ.
Grant this, O Lord.
Commemorating our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
Lord God Almighty, you alone, you are holy. You accept the sacrifice of praise from those who call upon you with their whole heart. Even so, accept from us sinners our supplication and bring it to your holy altar of sacrifice. Enable us to offer you gifts and spiritual sacrifices for our own sins and the failings of your people. Deem us worthy to find grace in your sight, that our sacrifice may be well-pleasing to you, and that the good spirit of your grace may rest upon us and upon these gifts presented, and upon all of your people. Please rise again if you can. Thank you.
Through the mercies of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all-holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Peace be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us love one another, that with one mind we may confess.
Christ is in our midst, he was, is, and always shall be. I will love you, Lord. The Lord is my rock. He is my protection. He is my fortress. He is my deliverer. Christ is in our midst, he was, is, and always shall be.
The doors, in wisdom let us be attentive.
Altogether, I believe in one God, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, suffered and was buried, and he rose on the third day according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the creator of life, proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets. In one holy Catholic and apostolic church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come.
Let us stand aright, let us stand in awe, let us be attentive, that we may present the holy offering in peace.
A mercy of peace,
a sacrifice of praise, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all.
And with your spirit.
Let us lift up our hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto the Lord.
It is
proper and right to him, to you, to bless you, to praise you, to give thanks to you, to worship you in every place of your dominion. For you, O God, are ineffable, inconceivable, invisible, incomprehensible, existing forever, forever the same, you and your only begotten Son, You and your Holy Spirit, you brought us out of nothing into being. And when we had fallen away, you raised us up again. You left nothing undone until you had led us up to heaven and granted us your kingdom, which is to come. For all these things, we thank you and your only begotten Son and your Holy Spirit, for all these things known and unknown, for blessings manifest and hidden that have been bestowed on us. We thank you also for this liturgy, which you have deigned to receive from our hands, even though thousands of archangels and tens of thousands of angels stand around you, the cherubim and seraphim, six-winged, many-eyed, soaring aloft upon their wings, singing the victory hymn, exclaiming, proclaiming, and saying, together with these blessed powers, Master, who loves mankind, we also exclaim and say, holy are you and most holy. You and your only begotten Son, holy and you are most holy and sublime. As you glory, you so love your will. That you gave your only begotten Son so that everyone who believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. When he had come and fulfilled for our sake the entire plan of salvation, on the night in which he was delivered up, or rather when he delivered himself up for the life of the world, he took bread in his holy, pure, and blameless hands, and giving thanks and blessing, he hallowed and broke it and gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you, for the remission of sins. Lavate, fiate, tutumo esti, to somam, to iberimon clomenon, isafesina martion. Likewise, after partaking of the supper, he took the cup, saying, drink of this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Pietex aptupantes, tuto esti toe mamu, totis canis thea fihikis, toi perimon kepolon ekinomenon, isafesina martion. Remembering therefore the saving commandment and all that has been done for our sake, the cross, the tomb, the resurrection on the third day, the ascension into heaven, the enthronement at the right hand, and the second glorious coming again, your own, of your own, we offer to you in all and for all. Once again, we offer to you the spiritual worship without the shedding of blood, and we beseech and pray and entreat you, send down your Holy Spirit upon us and upon the gifts here presented, and make this bread the precious body of your Christ.
Amen.
And that which is in this cup, the precious blood of your Christ.
Amen.
Changing them by your Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
So that they may be to those who partake of them for vigilance of soul, remission of sins, communion of your Holy Spirit, fullness of the kingdom of heaven, boldness before you, not for judgment or condemnation. Again, we offer you the spiritual worship for those who have reposed in the faith, forefathers, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, and for every righteous spirit made perfect in faith.
Especially for most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary.
For St. John the prophet, Forner, and Baptist, for the holy, glorious, and most praiseworthy apostles, in commemoration of St. George, the great martyr and standard bearer, whose memory we celebrate, and for all your saints, through whose supplications visit us, O God. Great is the name of the Holy Trinity, now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. And remember all who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection to life eternal. Remember, Lord, Michael the presbyter, Leonidas, and all of those today commemorated in the service of preparation, granting them rest, O God, where the light of your countenance keeps watch. Again, we beseech you, Lord, remember all Orthodox bishops who rightly teach the word of your truth, the presbyterate, the diaconate in Christ, and every priestly and monastic order. Again, we offer you the spiritual worship for the whole world, for the Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, and for those living pure and reverent lives, for civil authorities, grant that they may govern in peace, Lord, so that in their tranquility we too may live calm and serene lives in all piety and virtue. Remember, Lord, the city in which we live, and every city and land and the faithful who live in them. Remember, Lord, those who travel by land, sea, and air, for the sick, the suffering, the captives, and for their salvation. Remember those who bear fruit and do good works in your holy churches, and those who are mindful of the poor. And upon us all, send forth your mercies.
Among the first, remember Lord Archbishop and Father Methodios. Grant him to your holy churches in peace, safety, honor, and health unto length of days, rightly teaching the word of your truth. And remember those whom each of us has in mind, and all your people.
And all the people.
And grant that with one voice and one heart we may glorify and praise your most honorable and majestic name, of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
And the mercies of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, be with you all.
Can be seated. Please be seated, everyone.
Having commemorated all the saints again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Mercy.
For the precious gifts here presented and consecrated, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Let our God, who loves mankind, having accepted them at his holy and celestial and mystical altar as an offering of spiritual fragrance, may in return send down upon us divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray.
Lord,
having asked for the unity of the faith and for the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
We entrust to you, loving Master, our whole life and hope, and we beseech, pray, and implore you, grant us to partake of your heavenly and awesome mysteries from this sacred and spiritual table with a clear conscience, for the remission of sins, the forgiveness of transgressions, the communion of the Holy Spirit, the inheritance of the kingdom of heaven, and boldness before you, not unto judgment or condemnation. Please rise once again if you're able.
And grant, Master, with boldness and without condemnation, to dare call you the heavenly God, Father, and to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Pater imon, o endis oranis, agiestita to onomasu, el fetu i vasiliesu, genethito to thelimasu, os in orono qui epitiscis, tonar to limon ton abusion, dos imin simeron, και άφεσι μην το φιλήματο ημών, ως και εμείς εφιέμενης εφελέτης ημών, και μη εσενάγγις ημάς εις πυροσμών, αλλά ρίσαι ημάς από το πονηρού.
For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of angels. Peace be with you all.
Spirit.
Let us bow our heads unto the Lord.
We give thanks to you, invisible King, who by your boundless power fashioned the universe, and in the multitude of your mercy brought all things from nothing into being. Look down from heaven, O Master, upon those who have bowed their heads before you, for they have not bowed before flesh and blood, but before you, the awesome God. Therefore, O Master, make smooth and beneficial for us all whatever lies ahead according to the need of each. Sail with those who sail, travel with those who travel, heal the sick, physician of our souls and bodies. Through the grace, compassion, and love for mankind of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of angels.
Amen.
Hearken, O Lord Jesus Christ, our God, from your holy dwelling place and from the throne of glory of your kingdom, and come to sanctify us, you who are enthroned with the Father on high, and are present among us invisibly here, and with your mighty hand grant communion of your most pure body and precious blood to us and through us to all of your people. God, be gracious to me, a sinner, and have mercy upon me.
Let us be attentive. The holy gifts for the holy people of God, Zion, tis his.
The Lamb of God is broken, yet never divided, forever eaten, yet is never consumed, but he sanctifies those who partake of him, the fullness of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Blessed is the fervor of your saints now and ever into the ages of ages. Amen. Zestis pneumatos eiu. Amen. The warmth of the Holy Spirit.
I believe and confess, Lord, that this is truly the Christ, the Son of the living God, who came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the first. I also believe that this is truly your pure body, and that this is truly your precious blood. Therefore, I pray to you, have mercy upon me, and forgive me my transgressions, voluntary and involuntary, in word and deed, in knowledge or in ignorance, and make me worthy without condemnation to partake of your pure mysteries for the remission of sins and for eternal life. Amen. Behold, I approach for divine communion. O Maker, burn me not as I partake, for you are fire consuming the unworthy, but cleanse me from every stain. Tremble, O man, as you behold the divine blood. It is a burning coal that sears the unworthy. The body of God both deifies and nourishes me. It deifies the spirit and wondrously nourishes the mind. You have smitten me with yearning, O Christ, and by your divine arrows you have changed me. But burn up with my spiritual fire my sins, and grant me to be filled with delight in you, so that leaping for joy I may magnify, O good one, your two comings. How shall I, who am unworthy, enter into the splendor of your saints? As I should dare to enter the bridal chamber, my vest will condemn me, since it is not a wedding garment. And being bound up, I shall be cast out by the angels. Cleanse, O Lord, the filth of my soul, and save me, as you are the one who loves mankind. In your love, Lord, cleanse my soul and save me. Master who loves mankind, Lord Jesus Christ, my God, let not these holy gifts be to my judgment, because I am unworthy, but rather for the purification and sanctification of both soul and body, and the pledge of the life and kingdom to come. It is good for me to cleave unto God, and to place in him the hope of my salvation.
O Son of God, receive me today as a partaker of your mystical supper. For I will not speak of the mysteries to your adversaries, nor will I give you a kiss as the Judas, but like the thief I confess to you, remember me, Lord, in your kingdom. My brothers, forgive me. Brothers, forgive me. Brothers and sisters, children, forgive me. Behold, I approach Christ, our immortal King and God, the precious and most holy body of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ is given to me, Alexander, the unworthy priest, for the forgiveness of sins and life eternal. Amen.
Praise the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise, O you, O God, O Zion. Praise the Lord, O Jerusalem.
precious and most holy blood of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ has given to me, Alexander, the unworthy priest, for the forgiveness of sins and life eternal.
For he strengthens the bars of your gates, he blesses your children within you. Praise the Lord.
This has touched my lips, cleanses my iniquity.
Your borders peace and fills you with the finest
the fullness
of
the Holy Spirit, the fullness of the Holy Spirit.
Praise
the fullness of the Holy Spirit.
The Lord, O Jerusalem.
Having beheld the resurrection of Christ, let us worship the Holy Lord Jesus, the only sinless one. You cross, O Christ, we praise and glorify. For you are our God, apart from you we know no other.
He call who upon sends name, his come teaching faithful. To earth until his word
let us
shall
venerate
run swiftly.
The holy resurrection of Christ,
praise
for behold, through the cross, joy has come to the whole world. Ever blessed the Lord, let us praise his resurrection. Shine, shine, O New Jerusalem, for the glory of the Lord has dawned upon you. Dance now and be glad, Zion, and you, O pure Theotokos, rejoice in the resurrection of your Son. O voice divine, beloved, most sweet, for you, O Christ, have promised in truth to be with us until the close of the age, and we faithful rejoice, having this anchor of hope. O Christ, our Pascha, most sacred, great, wisdom, word, power of God, grant unto us to partake of you more profoundly in the unending day of your kingdom.
With the fear of God, with faith and with love, draw near.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good.
Alleluia. For his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
Oh, give thanks unto the God of gods.
Alleluia. For his mercy endureth forever. Endureth forever, alleluia.
To him who alone doeth great wonders,
alleluia. For his mercy endureth forever, alleluia.
To him that by wisdom made the heavens,
alleluia. For his mercy endureth forever, alleluia.
To him that stretched out the earth above the waters,
alleluia. For his mercy endureth forever, alleluia.
To him that made great
alleluia. For his mercy endureth forever, alleluia.
The sun to rule by day,
alleluia. For his mercy endureth forever, alleluia.
The moon and stars to rule by night,
alleluia. For his mercy endureth forever, alleluia.
to him that smote Egypt in their firstborn.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
Then brought out Israel from among them.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
With a strong hand and with a stretched out arm.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
To him which divided the Red Sea into parts.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
And made Israel to pass through the midst of it.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
But overthrew Pharaoh and his host in the Red Sea.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
To him which led his people through the wilderness.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
To him which smote great kings.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
And slew famous kings.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
Zion, king of the Amorites.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
And Og, the king of Bashan.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
And gave their land for a heritage.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
Even an heritage unto Israel his servant.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
Who remembered us in our low estate.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
Redeemed us from our enemies.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
Who giveth food to all flesh.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
Oh, give thanks unto the God of heaven.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
Give thanks unto the God of gods.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
Oh, give thanks unto the Lord of lords.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
To him who alone doeth great wonders.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia.
To him that by wisdom made the heavens.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever.
That stretch of the earth above the waters.
Alleluia, for his mercy endureth forever. Alleluia. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. Alleluia, for his mercy endureth.
O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance.
Christ is risen
from the dead. By death trampling down upon heaven
to the
blessed is our God,
now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Arise, having partaken of the divine, holy, pure, mortal, heavenly, life-giving, and awesome mysteries of Christ, let us worthily give thanks to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us. O God, by your grace,
Lord, have mercy.
Having prayed for a perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless day, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
We give thanks to you, Master, who loves mankind, benefactor of our souls, that even on this very day you have made us worthy again of your heavenly and immortal mysteries. Make straight our path, fortify us in your fear. Guard our life, make secure our steps through the prayers and supplications of the glorious Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, and of all your saints.
For you are sanctification, and to you we offer up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, who blesses those who bless you and sanctifies those who put their trust in you, save your people and bless your inheritance. Protect the whole body of your church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of your house. Glorify them in return by your divine power. And forsake us not who have set our hope in you. Grant peace to your world, to your churches, to the clergy, to our civic leaders, to the armed forces, and to all your people. For every good and perfect gift is from above, coming down from heaven, you, the Father of lights.
To you we give glory, thanksgiving, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Christ our God, you are the fulfillment of the law and the prophets,
blessed
who fulfilled
be the, name
the Father's entire
of the
plan of
Lord
salvation.
From this
fill our hearts
time
with joy and gladness,
the ages.
Now and always and forever.
Blessed be the name of
and
the
ever.
Lord.
Amen.
From this time forth and to the ages. Blessed be the name of the Lord, from this time forth and to the ages.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
May the blessing of the Lord and his mercy come upon you through his divine grace and love always, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to you, O God, glory to you. May he who rose from the dead, Christ our true God, through the intercessions of his all pure, all immaculate and holy mother, the power of the precious and life-giving cross, the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, the supplications of the honorable glorious prophet and foreigner John the Baptist, of the holy, glorious and praiseworthy apostles, the holy, glorious, and triumphant martyrs, of our righteous and God-bearing fathers, of St. Gregory, the Theologian, the patron saint of our church, of St. John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose liturgy we celebrate today, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim, Nana, and in commemoration of St. George, the great martyr and standard-bearer, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is a good God and loves humankind. Christ is risen.
Truly is risen.
Christos Anesti.
Aletheos Anesti.
Christ is risen.
Truly is risen.
Glory to his resurrection on the third day.
We worship his holy resurrection.
Let's try Albanian. Christi Injal. Let's try Romanian. Christos Inviat. Well done. Let's try Russian, Ukrainian. Christos Voskresi. Let's try Spanish, Cristo ha resucitado. Okay. Any other languages that we have? Call it out. Fair enough. Let's sing one more time together.
Christos ha nesti eg negro fanato fanaton ba. Jesus, Jesus, and Jesus, we must see. Zoe, Harisam.
Christ is risen from the dead. By death he is trampled upon death, bestowing life to those in the tomb.
Truly he is risen.
Christ is risen.
Truly he is risen.
Thank you. Please be seated. Thank you very much. Week as well, and it's a good kind of tired. It's like the kind of tired when you've had a really good but fruitful work day or several days, and you come back and you feel like you've really done something. And we did that on a spiritual level last week, and I know that it wasn't just that week because Lent itself has a lot of demands. We had some wonderful youth programs and events and many different things that we did in the services that led up to Holy Week and Pascha. I'll leave that to you, but I offered in this weekly email this week and today's bulletin just kind of a lengthy thank you. If you look on the left of your bulletin where it says in gratitude, that's from me to you. Please do read it when you can and see yourself there. You're all included in there. Too many people to list out and thank. It's really writing the name of the entire parish there, but you know your presence, you know your participation. God saw the beautiful holy works of that week, from connecting with people who hadn't been here in a while, to making sure that people had rides to church who wanted to come, to ministering to our youth, to singing, to greeting people, to cooking for people, to welcoming people, to donating, all kinds of wonderful things. Again, you are there within those words of thanksgiving, as is Father Manny. And I ask you, he couldn't be with us today, but when you see him next weekend, do thank your priest for Holy Week. Reach out to him, give him a hug. He loves to hug. And please do thank him for Holy Week. It's a wonderful thing to do. Today, a low-key day, but we do have fellowship hour. Invite you to come there. I believe today's fellowship hour is sponsored by our middle schoolers with a teacher, Mr. Kaufman. Thanks to all of them. If we look to next Sunday, it's the Sunday of the mare-bearing woman, a special Sunday for all of our young women and girls who are mare bearers. We'll say something about them and their ministry next week, but that is a joyous, radiant Sunday, as all of these post-Pascha Sundays are. With that in mind, too, and speaking of thank yous and gratitude, our stewardship committee did, in the last few weeks, have this beautiful magnet made. It's a pretty big magnet with our patron saint on it, and it's a Paschal gift. It's an Easter gift for all of us, and there's a bunch of them in the narthex today. So before you go down to the hall, or if you have to scoot, and if you haven't gotten one yet, go ahead and receive one of those magnets. I've got one on our fridge. It's a nice reminder that you belong to this parish home, and I thank Phil and our whole stewardship committee for making that happen. Again, it's a beautiful magnet, and again, it's a gift from us to all of you. I wanted to, as well, just draw your attention to a couple of things on the right-hand side of your program here. The Parasco Scholarship is for graduating seniors. Applications are due April 30th. So if you have a senior in your home who's going to a college, university, four-year program, what have you, next year, this is something you can apply to. There is a online application. There's a web address there within the blurb. And also, if you have questions, you can email the St. Gregory Scholarship at gmail.com and somebody will get right back to you. April 30th is the deadline, which is next Sunday, so it's racing toward us. And we want to be able to announce those when we have our Scholarship Sunday and high school graduation program in several weeks. So please do attend to that. The Metropolis Awards, which is that big event with about 800 people there, is going to be on June 11th, this year, June 11th, and that's going to be again at Gillette Stadium. If you went last year, it was pretty neat because in the little ball, not the little, but the big ballroom there, you can see the field and it's kind of an exciting atmosphere. And you can meet people before or after and run around the whole area there. There's restaurants and all kinds of fun places to go. So I encourage you to save the date. Also, a lot of times, many years, many parishes, we will raise somebody's name up, priest and parish council. But we wanted to augment that process and invite all of you to offer the name of somebody who you would like to nominate by April 28th, so several days away, but we have to get active on that as well. So by April 28th, if you can send a note or see me or Phil, that would be a wonderful thing to do, and we can kind of put the names together and raise someone up out of that list. And again, we're thinking about people who are wonderful stewards, their time and their talent to St. Gregory, people who are very faithful to the sacramental life of the church. So many people will come to mind, but maybe you can think of somebody who has not been honored yet over the years, and we can get together, put our heads together, and then there'll be another one next year after that. So there'll be room for everyone that we want to raise up over the years to come. And Philoptikos updates, moving down to the third block. Philoptikos wishes to thank everyone who offered donations for Dignity Matters Drive. I think I saw on the social media the Facebook page of our Philoptikos, a wonderful drop-off to Dignity Matters. I know they were very, very grateful for all of those products, helping women and girls and young women in our general area. So thank you all on behalf of Philoptikos. Also, Philoptikos board elections will be taking place mid-May, is that when it's going to be happening? And then I think we're looking for names for the board by the 6th of May. Is that okay to say that? I think that's the date that I saw from Anne's email. So May 6th or thereabouts to offer yourself as a candidate for the board. You can contact Ann Johnson, see a Philoptikos member. And couple of wonderful other events coming for Philoptikos. May 14th, the Sunday of the Samaritan Woman. That is the Philoptikos Day to say thank you to our parish for supporting its many ministries through a special fellowship hour. So May 14th, a fellowship hour. And then it looks like on Mother's Day weekend, on that Saturday, there's going to be a nail party. And not a nail party, but a nail party for everybody who's interested. I'm going to pass on that one. I'll come say hello, but I think I'm going to pass. I had enough of that when my kids were 3 or 4 years old and painted my nails when I was sleeping or something. But it's going to be, a wonderful event. Just stay tuned for more details. I think there may be refreshments, a little brunch, but a place to come and have somebody do your nails up in a really wonderful way just in time for Mother's Day. And this is a reminder to all those husbands here who have somebody who's a mother in their life. Get it in your head now. That's the day. And look for that present now. And don't wait till May 13th and a half or what have you. Make sure that you act on that whenever Mother's Day is. Really get on that. Looking below that, the Sunday school events, some dates to save. May 7th and June 4th, that will be the last 2 days before the summer when our youth sit up front. It's always a wonderful day. I'm so proud of our families and our young people for making that happen. They come right up front. They're present. Father Manny, myself, maybe Lee. We can convince Lee to offer something before the summer comes to our youth. It's always a very, very special day for we clergy and those who lead your children. May 21st, I mentioned Dr. Stavros will lead us through high school graduation recognition and also the scholarship event. Again, Parasco scholarships, April 30th deadline. And June 4th is the last day of Sunday school. Some gifts for our children, our teachers, and also, yes, an ice cream social. Very important things. So those are some things I wanted to highlight with you. One thing that I did not do yet is read the Paschal, the Easter letter from His Eminence, Metropolitan Methodios, to us in lieu of a homily offered by me today, which I've done plenty of talking over the last week or so, which I enjoy very much doing, but it's important to hear from our bishop. And he's always a powerful writer, a poignant writer. I'm going to read some of the highlights of his letter, because it's a couple of pages long before we go down to fellowship hour. And this was, to be clear, to be delivered at midnight, at that midnight hour or just after on Holy Saturday night, but I wanted to say some things of my own to you that night. So again, that's the context. It says, Easter Midnight Message 2023. His Eminence begins. Easter Sunday will arrive a little after midnight with a singular sacredness and grace. It comes with a joyous salvific message. Easter, or more correctly, Passover, Pascha, is the manifestation of God's love for us, a love that we clearly see in Christ the Savior, who suffered the betrayal, the trial, the passion, the suffering, the scourging, the beating, the crown of thorns, the humiliation of the cross of pain, and who rose on the third day that we may have forgiveness of sins and life everlasting. It is our Savior's resurrection from the tomb that becomes our Passover, our Pascha. One of the hymns this evening reads, quote unquote, Christ has brought us from death to life and from earth to life, and that is from the Paschal Canon, Ode 1. Darkness is the realm of the devil, of Satan, the father of lies and the prince of darkness. Darkness shrouds our lives with loneliness, addiction, pain, resentment. It permeates every aspect of our lives. It seeds controversy and division, which result in troubled marriages, dysfunctional families, and broken friendships. In his darkness, Satan encircles the world in what seems to be an endless circle of controversies, of violence, and of wars. The devil is the source of satanic lies and vindictiveness which emanate from unbridled egos. Satan is the manifestation of selfishness, of racism, of homelessness, and hopelessness. Living as we do in a world so often blinded by the darkness of despair, of hatred, and calculated cruelty, and of crime, of terrorism, and of war, we approach the life-giving tomb as a people of faith to fill our hearts, our minds, our souls with a radiant light, the truth and joy of our Lord's resurrection. We gather at the life-giving tomb to learn from the archangel the joyous news that Christ is risen. In turn, we intend to inform those who attempt to muzzle the voice of Christianity and the voice of hope, and to drive the church out of the daily life of this nation, that they labor in vain. We have something to herald to a broken world. What we have to say is Christ is risen. We say tonight to our brethren that have been victimized in different ways within our country and throughout the world, to all who have been disillusioned, disappointed, betrayed, and abandoned, the homeless, the hungry, the lonely, and forgotten, that Christ is risen and the ultimate victory is his. In the seemingly impenetrable gloom of hopelessness and death, the resurrection of our Savior comes as an eruption of blinding light. The lifeless tomb of darkness which held captive Adam and Eve and all their descendants is thrown open by him who is life itself. The risen Lord leads our Passover, our Pascha. A new creation is born. Saint Peter teaches in his first epistle, quote unquote, by his great mercy, we have been born anew to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. And that's 1 Peter 1:3. We are determined to share that faith and that joy in this city, in this commonwealth, in this nation, and in every corner of the earth. We believe that only the radiant light of Christ can transfigure enmity, strife, and conflict of faithlessness, hopelessness, apathy, and indifference of selfishness and narcissism into a community of believers, into a faith, into a family of brothers and sisters of faith, of virtue, of love, of hope, of empathy and concern. And so let us advance fearlessly into a world mired in darkness, armed with the unwaning light of the life-giving tomb. Let us embrace one another and share the light for all who await a personal Pascha with archpastoral love, Metropolitan Methodios. I thank His Eminence for sharing this with us, and I'm really touched by that idea at the end of a personal Pascha. The letter is heavily laden with that word hopelessness. I think if I counted up how many times, it might be 8, 9, 10 times, and images of bleakness and images of distortion, things like narcissism. All of these things are what we're talking about when we say from the Gospel of John, the light that shines in the darkness. What is that darkness? What is the darkness of the church just before the resurrection service supposed to mean? If you were here that night, you might have noticed that I told people after the little homily that we were going to let it be dark for a while and that we're going to be comfortable in that, with that discomfort, comfortable with that discomfort, be a little edgy in our seats. It's kind of strange to be in the dark and have it be quiet and kind of, you know, waiting for the next thing to happen. So to let ourselves just kind of be alone with maybe the darkness that we sometimes are burdened with in our hearts. All of the things that His Eminence said are very real, from war to destruction, to dissolution of friendships. Broken marriages, hurting marriages were mentioned. Addiction was mentioned. Every one of our families, I would hazard to say, every one of our families is touched right now on some level by addiction or the repercussions of some sort of addiction. And if you talk to people who have been deep and are deep in that realm, swim in that ocean, that's darkness. That's darkness. That's real darkness. And so what we're reaching toward here is what comes in the midst of that darkness. What rescues us from that? It's Christ. It's Christ, our true God. It's the blazing flame of His resurrection and of love. If you see the wonderful, you know, images from Pascha throughout the world, it's just an amazing thing when you see the 33, you know, candles kind of bound together, representing the number of Christ's years on earth. When that powerful sacred moment comes, when the patriarch comes from the tomb of the Holy Sepulchre, and that thing is just blazing, it's burning, it's just amazing. It's like the sun. That's what's happening in our lives. And the real challenge is, how does that light look in our life? We know how the rest of it looks. We know how the darkness looks, but what does it look to have that light? What does it look like to be more compassionate, to talk to our spouses about why our marriages are hurting, to talk to people about why our friendships are broken up or we haven't talked in a long time, to talk about what is wrong or hurting or dysfunctional at work or at church or among neighbors or organizations that we belong to talk about why we feel hopelessness or lost in different ways, and to try to get somewhere and try to discover that joy and try to heal things and try to build our lives up by Christ's love, to offer ourselves, to give of ourselves, to feel that in our heart, to feel that churn in our heart. If we're prodigal, to come home to the Father who is waiting for us with great open arms, ready to kiss away, as we always say, to kiss away the rehearsed confession of the prodigal son, just joyful to have received the prodigal son, the prodigal daughter, the prodigal child, the prodigal you, the prodigal me. So with those things, I'll leave it there. Please do join us downstairs for fellowship hour. If you can, don't forget your magnet. Don't forget Mother's Day weekend with the nails and all the other stuff that I mentioned. And I'm so happy to have you on this glorious day at our church. And again, thank you, and thank you for a wonderful, great Lent and Holy Week, and of course, Pascha. Christ is risen. I did kind of give you another homily anyway, didn't I? I didn't mean to. But I guess maybe I went on longer than the letter.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee. Heavenly King, O Comforter, the Spirit of Truth, who art everywhere present and fillest all things, O Treasury of every good and bestower of life, come and dwell in us and cleanse us from every stain and save our souls, O Good One. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Aios o Theos, Aios Ischiros, Aios o Thanatos, eleison imas. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. All Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, be gracious unto our sins. Master, pardon our iniquities. Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities, for thy name's sake. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us. Amen. As we rise from sleep, we fall down before thee, O Good One, and we cry unto thee with the hymn of the angels, O Mighty One. Holy, holy, holy art thou, O God, through the Theotokos have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, Having raised me from bed and from sleep, O Lord, enlighten my mind and my heart, and open thou my lips, that I may praise thee, O Holy Trinity. Holy, holy, holy art thou, O God, through the Theotokos have mercy on us, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Of a sudden the judge shall come, and the deeds of each shall be laid bare. But let us cry out with fear in the midst of the night. Holy, holy, holy art thou, O God, through the Theotokos have mercy on us. Kyrieleison, 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 Kyrieleison. As I rise from sleep, I thank thee, O Holy Trinity, for because of thy great goodness and long-suffering, thou wast not wroth with me, the slothful and sinner, nor didst thou destroy me in mine iniquities, but didst show thy wonted love for man. And when I was prostrate in despair, thou didst raise me to keep the morning watch and glorify thy dominion. And now enlighten thou the eyes of my mind, open my mouth to meditate on thy words and to understand thy commandments, and to do thy will, and to chant unto thee in heartfelt confession, and praise thine all-holy name, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. O come, let us worship and fall down before our King and God. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ, our King and God. O come, let us worship and fall down before Him, Christ the King and our God. Have mercy on me, O God, according to thy great mercy, and according to the multitude of thy compassions, blot out my transgression. Wash me thoroughly from mine iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know mine iniquity, and my sin is ever before me. Against thee only have I sinned, and done this evil before thee, that thou mightest be justified in thy words, and prevail when thou art judged. For behold, I was conceived in iniquities, and in sins did my mother bear me. For behold, thou hast loved truth, the hidden and secret things of thy wisdom hast thou made manifest unto me. Thou shalt sprinkle me with hyssop, and I shall be made clean. Thou shalt wash me, and I shall be made whiter than snow. Thou shalt make me to hear joy and gladness. The bones that be humbled, they shall rejoice. Turn thy face away from my sins, and blot out all mine iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and with thy governing spirit establish me. I shall teach transgressors thy ways, and the ungodly shall turn back unto thee. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, thou God of my salvation. My tongue shall rejoice in thy righteousness. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise. For if thou hadst desired sacrifice, I had given it. With whole burnt offerings thou shalt not be pleased. A sacrifice unto God is a broken spirit. A heart that is broken and humbled God will not despise. Do good, O Lord, in thy good pleasure unto Zion, and let the walls of Jerusalem be builded. Then shalt thou be pleased with a sacrifice of righteousness, with oblation and whole burnt offerings. Then shall they offer bullocks upon thine altar. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. And in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages. Light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father through whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, and suffered and was buried. And he rose on the third day, according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge the living and dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets. In one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen. Thee do we bless, thou most high God and Lord of mercy, who ever workest with us deeds great and unfathomable, glorious and extraordinary, whereof there is no number, who hast given unto us sleep for rest from our infirmity and for repose of our much toiling flesh. We thank thee that thou hast not destroyed us in our iniquities, but hast shown thy wonted love for man, and though we were prostrate in despair, thou hast raised us up to glorify thy dominion. Wherefore, we beseech thine incomparable goodness, enlighten the eyes of our understanding, and raise our mind from the heavy sleep of slothfulness. Open our mouth and fill it with thy praise, that we may be able undistracted to sing and chant and give thanks unto thee, who art God, glorified in all and by all, the beginningless Father, with thine only begotten Son, and thine all-holy and good and life-creating Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Most glorious, ever-Virgin, blessed Theotokos, present our prayer to thy Son and our God, and pray that through thee he would save our souls. My hope is the Father, my refuge the Son, my shelter the Holy Spirit,